Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So I hope that you guys are doing well in your studies. And in today's video, we are going to discuss a lot of important reports. So let's begin today's video. But if you have not subscribed our channel till now, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where you can get the free quizzes as well as the latest updates about exams. And this is the new course for RBI Grade B 2022. Here you will get PDFs, mocks and video lectures along with your mock interview. So we conduct mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your final interviews of RBI Grade B. And you will also get a booklet that contains all the books mentioned right in front of you. And right now we are running a 30% discount on the course. So if you are willing to avail that discount, you can use the RBI 30 coupon code in order to avail that discount. And right now, this is the number which you can use if you have any query related to the examination or related to our course. Now let's move on to the first question. What is India's rank in Global Startup Ecosystem Index 2021? So first of all, this report is released by Startup Blink. Quite an easy name to be memorized. Startup Blink releases this Global Startup Ecosystem report. Now India's rank is 20th. India has ranked 20th out of a total of 100 countries. So this is a very good ranking that India has achieved in terms of its conducivity towards startups. Guys, you should also be aware of this fact that India is the third largest startup ecosystem in the world as per the data of NASSCOM. Okay, so we are really thriving in terms of startups. Now this ranking is not alone, it has come with a score. So what is India's score actually? So India's score is 8.8 and the ranking is 20 out of the 100 countries. Now let us understand about the other details that this index has. Guys, first of all, you should know that this index has ranked not only the countries but also the cities in the countries. So a total number of 100 countries have been ranked. So for the countries, there is a separate ranking, and for cities, there is a separate ranking. The total number of cities that were assessed is 1000. Now, which country is at the top? So we have US, UK, Israel, Canada, and Germany at the top respectively. And then in terms of cities, San Francisco Bay, New York, Beijing, Los Angeles, and London are among the top 5 cities in the world in terms of startup ecosystem. When it comes to Indian cities, Bangalore is at the 10th position. Bangalore is the top performer. The position is the global ranking. But if you compare it with the other cities of India, so Bangalore is the top performer in this index. Then we have New Delhi and Mumbai at the following rankings. India is the third largest startup ecosystem that we have already discussed. But what are the parameters on which these cities and countries have been ranked? So there are three dimensions: quantity of the startups, like number of startups, number of startup meetings, and there are other indicators as well which were there inside these dimensions, but you don't have to go into those indicators. Just memorize these three broad dimensions on which the countries and cities were measured. Next is quality of startups, and the third one is business environment. So these are the three parameters on which the cities as well as countries were ranked. Now my question from you is that where is this Startup Blink located? This is probably not a very important question that might come in your examination, but it is for your general awareness that I am asking you this question. So do mention it in the comment section below, where is this Startup Blink located? Moving on to the next question, this is again a very important question, guys. With which company did Science and Engineering Research Board partner to launch Fund for Industrial Research Engagement, which is abbreviated as FIRE? So this FIRE can be asked from you in your examination. You have to memorize the full form of this FIRE as well. That is Fund for Industrial Research Engagement. Now let's see the options. Reliance, HCL Technologies, IBM, Intel India, and Microsoft are in the options, and the right answer is Intel India. So guys, this is the first of its kind government industry collaboration for promoting research in different technologies, for example AI, machine learning, and there are different aspects of technologies that are emerging in the world at present. So in order to develop and promote research and development in those technologies, the government has partnered with the industry. So the first industry is Intel India, and from now onwards the government is going to partner with different industries so that the research can be promoted in different aspects, because the government needs industrial output, the government needs the contribution of the industry so that it can step forward in the field of new technologies. Therefore, this government industry initiative has taken place. Now, what is the mechanism? What is the actual function of this FIRE? So this is basically a fund for industrial research engagement, and this is basically a initiative under which the research will be co-funded by the government as well as the industry. So here in this case, Intel India and the CERB, which is a statutory body under the Department of Science and Technology, Ministry of Science and Technology. Okay. So these two organizations will co-fund the research and development in different fields of technology. So at present, this much information is relevant for your examination, particularly phase one examination, if any exam question comes from this FIRE initiative. Remember guys, it is Intel India. Now from here, I would like to ask a question from you. Who is the present head of this Intel India? Tell me in the comment section below. Okay, so this is our next report. Which city is the best performer in India in terms of being a technology center as per the growth engines of innovation, how Asia Pacific technology hubs are reshaping regional real estate report? So first of all, you should know that this report has been released by an organization named Collier International, and this organization is located in Canada. That was for your basic information. Now as far as this report is concerned, so we have Bangalore, New Delhi, Mumbai, Cochin, Kundakulam in the options, out of which Bangalore is the right answer. So Bangalore is the best performer in India in terms of being the technology center. Now you should also know this fact about this report, that this report has divided cities as well as sub markets. So for example, New Delhi is a city, but Lajpat Nagar, Sarojini Market or the markets like these are the sub markets. That was for example. Now these cities are different. For example, let's take the example from this report only. So New Delhi is the city that has been given a different ranking in the rankings among the cities only. And the sub-market in the New Delhi for technology center is NCR, the National Capital Region, where you have Noida, you have Gurgaon. So these are the technology hubs surrounding the New Delhi city. So that becomes the sub-market. So in terms of sub-market, a different ranking has been given to the NCR. Okay, I hope that this much is clear to you. Now let us dig deep into this index. Okay, according to this report, Bangalore is ranked among the top 5 technology centers in Asia Pacific, wherein Beijing is the top, and Shanghai, Bangalore, Shenzhen and Singapore are the following cities. Okay, so these above mentioned top places are the best places or the emerging places for the technology in the Asia Pacific region. So remember, we are talking about the Asia Pacific region here. In terms of technology submarkets, Shangdi in Beijing, Yangpu in Shanghai, High Tech City, Suburban Business District in Hyderabad, as well as Sydney's CBD South, Whitefield and North Bangalore in Bangalore are the top performers. So here these submarkets have been given in different cities. So these are the submarkets for which a different section in this report was dedicated. So I hope that this much is clear to you guys. Now we are moving on to the next report. Which is the least expensive city as per the Mercer 2021 cost of living city ranking? Tunis, Bern, Geneva, Bishkek and Beirut, out of which Bishkek is the right answer and it is the capital of Kyrgyzstan. Okay, and now let us understand the facts about this report. First of all, you should know that Bishkek has got that ranking out of 209 cities. So a total of 209 cities were ranked, and Bishkek is at the 209th position in this city, because they have been ranked on the basis of their expensiveness. So the most expensive city, that is Ashgabat, which is in Turkmenistan, is the most expensive city, whereas Bishkek is the least expensive. Now in case of India, Mumbai is the top expensive city in India with the rank of 78th. And other Indian cities which have been ranked in this index are New Delhi at 117th position, Chennai at 158th and Bangalore at 117th position. So Mumbai is the most expensive city to live in India. Now, guys, this is our last question. When is the International Day of Parliamentarianism observed? So, June 30, July 23, July 2nd, June 28, June 15, these are the options, out of which June 30 is the right answer. Now, you would be thinking that does this day also have a theme? So, here my answer is no, because this day did not have any theme. There are some important national days that do not have a theme for a particular year, but that does not reduce the importance of that day. So, you have to memorize the date of this International Day of Parliamentarianism. For today, that was all. Thank you so much for watching the video. And if you have enjoyed it, then do not forget to like it and share it among your friends. Thank you so much.